Here I have a grammar that we've seen before, but I've abbreviated it still further. Instead of identifier, I've just written ID, and instead of number, I've just written num. This sort of abbreviation is all too common in computer science. Programmers can't help it. Unfortunately, it's a bit of a vice, because while it's easy for me to see what's going on, it can be hard for someone reading it later, myself included, to tell what my variable names mean. Whenever possible, you should take the time to make your variable names as descriptive as possible, add lots of comments. It turns out that 90% of software is maintenance. Just like a popular book is read many more times than it's written, a program is read or maintained or executed many more times than it's written. So it's worth taking the time to do it right the first time. That said, clearly, I'm not. So this must be one of those do what I say and not what I do bad professor sorts of maneuvers. Regardless, back on track. Here's the grammar. Statement goes to identifier equals expression, and expression is the same sort of arithmetic we've seen before. We're now going to consider this particular sentence. Yggdrasil equals 6 minus 5. So I've written out a parse tree, a bit squashed at the bottom, but still recognizable, for this phrase, Yggdrasil equals 6 minus 5, but I've forgotten two labels. It's quiz time. Fill in the blanks. What would have to go in each of these blanks in order for this parse tree to match this input utterance according to this grammar?